Benedict, it's such a pleasure to have you here with me today, and welcome everyone to Yoho 2021, the series that basically gives you information, dispels all your fears and misconceptions, and educates you about your entire home acquisition journey, how you can really get your dream home. Now, we've touched on misconceptions, we've touched on your frequently asked questions, but today we're really delving into the products, one of the products under the entire home loan portfolio. Today we're discussing 100% purchase, and here with me today I have Benedict, who's going to expand and also clarify, because some of these expressions are very, very confusing. I can relate to that. So let us discuss this in detail with Benedict. Now, Benedict, tell us, what really is 100% purchase?
Thank you, Michelle, for having me on your show today, and greetings to your cherished viewers. I'm always happy to talk to you.
Oh, thank you, Benedict.
Okay, so the 100% purchase is one of the products that I'm always happy to talk about when I'm called upon. This is the reason. It seeks to solve a lot of problems for Ghanaians, because it's always not easy to raise the required minimum deposit towards home acquisition.
I wish you could say that like 100 times, because it's such a big issue. A lot of people find that as one of the biggest deterrents and one of the most difficult challenges to overcome, because finding the deposit to get your dream home, sometimes the bulk money is not available. So are you saying that First National Bank is providing a solution for this problem?
Yes, Michelle. First National Bank offers every Ghanaian resident the opportunity to acquire his or her first primary residence. What happens is that if you are unable to raise the required minimum deposit, you are still allowed to talk to First National Bank. We have a product called the 100% purchase. What this product seeks to solve is that those without the required minimum deposit are able to afford or secure 100% financing from First National Bank, where we pay for the full cost of the property without any contribution from the applicant.
I literally want to put on my sneakers and run to First National Bank at this point. When you say you're willing to pay the full purchase value of someone's dream home, there must be a catch in there somewhere. There must be some kind of a catch. What is the criteria, really?
That is also very simple. This is a problem solver, and so it's been made very simple for every Ghanaian resident to be able to assess it. What we do is that there is a limit on the income the person should be earning to qualify for this particular product. Because it's a problem solver, we think that if you earn more than the equivalent of 4,000 USD, the person or the applicant should not earn more than Ghana Cedi equivalent of $4,000.
Okay.
Yes, to be able to qualify for this product.
Okay. But I know that there is another condition under this 100% purchase product, which is, and I think from conversations that we've had before, you mentioned that there is an insurance cover of some kind. Can you specify that?
You know, already there's the property insurance cover, and then there's life insurance cover for the protection of the mortgage. These insurance covers are different. There's also another insurance cover called the collateral replacement indemnity.
Okay, so that is the collateral replacement indemnity.
Yes.
Okay, so what does that really mean?
Okay, the collateral replacement indemnity, as the name goes, is a replacement of the collateral. So the 30% that the customer would have contributed towards the acquisition of the property, the bank is providing 100% financing. However, there is a little catch over here.
Okay.
What happens is that the bank will be required, or the customer will be required, to take additional insurance cover over the portion that he or she was supposed to contribute.
Okay.
So the 30% minimum deposit requirement will be covered by an insurance policy called the collateral replacement indemnity.
Okay.
What this serves to achieve is that should anything happen within the first 3 years or more after disbursement of the facility, if anything happens to the customer or the applicant, the insurance company will step in to take care of the 30% that the customer should have contributed towards the acquisition of the property.
I think that's a solution on its own, because a lot of people might find it difficult, and I'm sure most of you are in agreement with me, in collating, gathering, consolidating this 30% minimum requirement deposits to acquire your dream home. So this to me is definitely a solution. Does this mean that there are other insurance covers aside the collateral indemnity cover that the customer or the applicant has to have in addition to this to be able to apply for the 100% purchase?
There is this insurance policy called the property insurance, and then there is life insurance. So these two, together with the collateral replacement indemnity, will be three insurances. Good. So what this serves to achieve is that the property insurance, if anything should happen to the building, any unforeseen circumstance should happen to the building, whether fire, earthquake, or anything to happen to the building, to destroy the building, insurance company will be called upon to reinstate the building for you. That is one. The second insurance policy is the mortgage protection, or the life insurance policy. This is taking, said that if anything should happen to the applicant himself, whether death or anything of that sort, the insurance company will step in and pay the full cost of the mortgage so that the bank will not have to touch the property in the absence or by death of the applicant.
Okay. Yeah. And then the third one is what you've obviously mentioned.
Yes, so the third one is the collateral replacement indemnity, which is taking to cover the extra 30% that the customer should have contributed, that the bank took over.
Now, in terms of these three different insurance covers that one has to have, is there a specific premium that the customer or the applicant must be paying on all three, or is it all put together?
Normally, these insurances are taken with different insurance companies or providers, so the premiums are not put together. However, the bank can always put together the total sum for the customer to know exactly how much he or she is supposed to pay every month to the bank. So the collateral replacement indemnity will be taken with another insurance company, different from the life insurance policy and then the property insurance policy.
But can the customer also decide that they want to have, just so that they can have one, they can streamline all their covers and all of their documentation from one source? Do you also have a list of recommendations in terms of insurance companies that the customer or the applicant can use?
Yes, we have a list of recommended insurance companies or providers. However, the customer is also allowed to bring any insurance provider he or she prefers. There is no, it's not a strict requirement that they go with our list of providers.
Okay.
However, yes, we have our list and we can provide that to the customer. The customer can choose from this list. Normally, we don't do all three insurances with one company in the sense that you have to always spread your risk. If anything should happen to the insurance company, it means all three policies will elapse. The bank will not be able to recover that money from the insurance company.
Okay,
so we normally spread
sense.
The insurance companies.
That makes a lot of sense. So Benedict, can you just give us a list of the rundown that everybody has to take note of, especially if they're interested in the 100% purchase where they don't have to necessarily make a deposit, because usually you have to make a deposit to be able to get your dream home. So please take us through the list of things that they need to be looking out for.
Thank you, Michelle. The process is very simple and straightforward. First, you need to speak to a sales consultant or mortgage advisor from the bank. So FNB has sales consultant, mortgage advisors who are experts in the field of mortgage.
Okay.
Yes, so you speak to them, they will let you have a copy of the application form, they will guide you through the filling or completing of it. So you complete the application form, and then the list of requirements, which can be seen on our website, you attach all those things to it, and then the sales consultant will forward it to the back office staff of the bank. When the application is received, the second step will be for the bank to issue what we call the letter of intent, LOI. So this letter of intent is actually to let the customer know that the application pack has been received by the bank. The bank is going to look at it, process it, and give a decision. However, the decision is going to take this format. So the letter of intent will give an intent of the bank in giving you the mortgage. The next step, which will be the third step, is that the customer will have to look at the letter of intent, sign on it, and return a copy to the bank. When the copy is received, then the fourth step will come in. Okay, so the bank will do all the paperwork and come out with a decision whether to accept the application by granting the loan or declining the request. So when the loan is granted or approval is given, the bank will issue what we call the facility letter. The facility letter is actually an approval letter that will confirm to the customer that the mortgage request the customer made has been accepted or approved by the bank. and the customer will be required to go through the facility letter, go through the terms and conditions. Conditions will be both precedent to disbursement and post-disbursement. If the customer is fine with all the terms and conditions, the customer will be required to sign on the facility letter and return a copy to the bank. When a copy of the facility is returned to the bank will proceed to call in for closing of the transaction. So the customer will have to come in to sign what we call the mortgage agreement. When this is signed and the facility is closed, then the next step will be for the bank to disburse the loan to the customer.
And that's the part that we all look forward to, the end part where we actually receive our signature on the dotted line and we officially start the journey of acquiring our dream home. Now, if you have any more questions, don't forget that you can contact anyone at the First National Bank at any branch near you. And I hope that today was useful, it was insightful, it was helpful, and also very educative. Don't forget that at the end of the day, your journey in acquiring your dream home is possible with First National Bank, because we say, First National Bank, how can we help you?